I'll never forget.
I'm here with John Bray, longtime trainer. He used to spar the likes of Mike Tyson. The sparring was so good, nobody could even talk about what happened that day. You remember those days you sparred him?
Those are great days. Loved it.
And they sent you home shortly thereafter because it was too good work.
It was great work.
And today, when Mike Tyson sees you, what does he say? You're the guy.
Oh, we're brothers. You know, he's a great guy. Good people.
What's the one thing you remember from that day of sparring Tyson?
I remember thinking, I couldn't believe how hard he was. Like, I remember you hearing all these ideas in, that people have that, you know, he's a big puncher and everything else, and sharp and heavy. But, I mean, for his size, just a tremendous puncher.
Mike Tyson, you did good against him in sparring. Did he tell you anything afterwards? Like, John Bray, you're actually pretty good. Did he say anything like that?
No, I mean, just, you know, mutual respect.
But he was impressed that you didn't cave in and get knocked down?
I never quit. I took my beatings like a good guy.
Nah, but you made it competitive.
I got my...
Did anybody record it? Because today it would have been on Twitter, Instagram.
I don't know. I'm not aware.
Now, speaking of Mike Tyson, he became super successful, and his success, then he went really downhill, then he made it back up. Now he's popular again. John, tell me about when you see fighters, doesn't matter, become super successful, and sometimes they change on us. They become Hollywood, or can you explain to me how to handle success as fighters?
You know, how you handle success, you know, in boxing is going to define you in life. And, you know, it's the hardest thing to deal with. It can make you or break you. Guys have become successful and have broken themselves, and guys have become successful and have been able to handle it and have gone on and catapulted into other things. Definitely, you know, there's a separation there. There's a separation of the people that can handle it and the people that do handle it and the people that can't handle it.
Tell me, give me an example. What happens to someone that can't handle success?
The best example is Mike Tyson. We saw a guy that couldn't handle the success and went spiraling downhill, got it all together, and was able to be successful once again and put it all back together.
And learn from the first time.
Absolutely.
Tell me about a fighter that became superstar but handled success in class, like a Sugar Ray Leonard, like a Mikey Garcia, like a Canelo.
Oh, I mean, you got to look at Sugar Ray Leonard, you got to look at Muhammad Ali. I mean, successful people.
That have not changed, have not let it affect them.
It hasn't affected them.
So when you meet a fighter that you knew as a kid, that becomes a champion now, and now he's too good for you. How do you act? How do you handle it?
I laugh. I think it's funny. It's
Does it happen sometimes?
Oh, it happens all the time.
When they were nobodies, they loved you.
Yeah.
But now, back then, they didn't know you. Now.
They'll even pretend like they didn't see you. They won't even make eye contact with you because they're too busy.
And then when they get hurt or stopped or can't get a fight and you're in speed dial?
Absolutely.
And what do you do then?
You know what? I'm the kind of guy like, I'm not going to shun you off. I'm cool. I'm going to be here with you. And, you know, whatever I need to help. I'm just here to help.
There you have it, John Bray. People want to get a hold of you. What, Facebook? Twitter? Facebook. Instagram? Facebook.
Yep, on Facebook.
@ John Bray. FusionRoupon.com and Ballistic Back Reporting.